Please join me in welcoming Beverly Byerman King, owner of Work Smart, Live Smart, to the stage.
So what do you think of when I say toxic workplaces? What comes to mind? ABC, attitude, behavior, poor communication? Is it micromanaging leadership? Is it gossiping, harassment, bullying? So we're going to talk about terminating toxicity within our workplaces. So in thinking about this, I love this definition for toxic: harsh, malicious, harmful. A workplace can be considered toxic if it's detrimental to the employee, if it's detrimental to the business bottom line. What do we know from our research? Toxic employees breed toxic workplaces. Toxic workplaces breed toxic employees. And so we're going to talk about how to act rather than react when it comes to dealing with these people. Why do we struggle as leaders? I think we struggle for a number of reasons. I think we struggle because we don't have enough time to deal with all of the people issues. I think we struggle because we're frustrated, and you'd be frustrated because people should just know how to get along. And I also think because we often deal with the surface issues. Well, why do we talk about this? And I think we talk about this because 2023, 2024 is really about workplace. It's a culture that's the year of workplace culture. And understanding that it has an impact on who we are, this toxicity impacts the culture. One of the challenges I find is that I talked about is leadership attentiveness. I think as leaders, like I said, our bucket is overflowing with too much to do and not enough time to do it in. And so we ignore that person who is toxic or negative. I think we need to change our thinking. The very best leaders get highly attentive in these situations, and they change their thinking, say, hey, that person's behavior right now, it's causing all kinds of problems for the organization. And I'm going to do what I can to help them to change. And if they do, great. And if they don't, I'm going to do what I need to do to protect the team. It really is about leadership. It matters. Those small things matter, and they impact the culture. So we need to plan ahead. We need to think about these keys when it comes to terminating toxicity. And I talk about these seven keys and some of the mistakes that we make. The first one is that we don't plan ahead. We jump right into the conversation, but we need to plan it out. We need to do our research. We need to rehearse. We need to think about, how is this person likely to respond in this situation? Think about those different things that could throw us off of our game, and rehearse the different scenarios over and over again. We need to listen more. I think one of the challenges is leaders that we talk far too much, which is funny for me as a speaker, but we need to talk. You know, we need to listen more. We need to start the conversation by thinking or by asking, what's working well? What's not working well? Because that will give us an idea of what we need to do. We need to check in. Do I have this right? Is there anything more that you would like to add? Gathering up that information. We also need to set the boundaries. What do I mean by setting the boundaries? What are your expectations? What is it that we are doing? Put your cards on the table. What is the goal of having this conversation? You know, it really is about creating this productive and engaged workforce. We need to focus on behaviors. You know, keep judgments out of the equation. Here's where your behaviors are effective. Here's where they are not so effective. We need to outline it for them. We need to move into problem solving. Don't make the mistake of thinking that a really good employee would know how to fix the situation, or even that their behaviors are a problem in the first place. One of the biggest mistakes I see is the failure around the follow through. We don't follow up on it because we know that follow up is one of the biggest predictors of success, of change in their behavior, but we often miss that. Here's what turning this situation around looks like. We need to document that. We need to be intentional. What does that mean when it comes to creating the culture that we desire? Be intentional. Hire, fire, and promote based on your values. Train on those values. Make decisions based on those values. Define what that culture looks like. Define what those values mean, because that's how employees become successful, when they know what the expectations are. So what do? We talk about, how do you go from gossiping and harassment and bullying and toxic? We need to make sure that we look at, what are the behaviors that we're seeing in our organization? We need to talk about, what impact is that having on the people around? And then we need to very quickly coach, address, and counsel. This is about dealing with difficult people. It is about the toxicity. And part of our job is to understand how contagious it is, how detrimental it is, and be able to go from acting or from reacting, acting to reacting.
There we go.